Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. If you guys have any of the following three cars, guys, Chrysler 200, Fiat 500 or Dodge Ram ProMaster, guys, with a 2.4 multi-air engine, and you have an oil leak from the timing cover, or you need to, guys, remove the timing cover to work on something, let's say you need to replace timing chain tensioner, guide or something like that, or even timing chain, we'll explain, guys, what needs to be done from start to finish to remove your timing cover and what needs to be done to reseal it later. Now, you do not have to, guys, remove the engine out of the car. We have that engine out because we'll be having, guys, more than 100 videos on that engine alone, and we want to show you with a great detail how to fix anything on it, guys, where every single bolt is located. That way it will be easier for you to figure out how to do it. Now, in addition, guys, every car we get at the shop, we'll be making 200 videos. Our mission, guys, here at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment below, let us know if the video was helpful. So let's go ahead and start on the timing cover replacement now. First, guys, before we remove the timing cover, we will have to go ahead and remove the valve cover. Why? Because there is, guys, okay, three bolts here, and we'll need to remove the valve cover because otherwise later you won't be able to install the timing cover if the valve cover is there. You might be able to remove it, but you won't be able to install it correctly, so you need to remove the valve cover in order to do it the correct way. So let's start on it and we'll continue. So when you open the hood of your car, you're going to face this way. You need to remove your engine cover. In order to remove the engine cover, guys, you just pull it straight out. Okay, it attaches to these four places on the valve cover. Here you will have your air filter box. You need to get that clamp loose so you can pull the hose back, and this will be a vacuum hose attached to the air filter hose box that you need to remove. After that, you need a clip removal too, guys, and right here you will have one clip that you need to remove. You'll be just like that clip here, guys, but this is broken. Next, 10 millimeter socket, guys, and we're going to go ahead, okay, and remove that bolt. Perfect. After that, guys, what needs to be done? You will need to disconnect the sensor for the intake temperature sensor, and then you have one hose clamp, okay, for the let me focus there quick. This is for the throttle body. Get that one loose, guys, and after that, go ahead and pull it out. Perfect. You can see it came out just like that. Now, what else we need to do? We need to start, guys, with wiring harness, disconnecting wiring harness and all that stuff. So that will take quite a bit of work now. We're going to start now, guys. Okay, here we have a few clips. Okay, so if you grab it with, okay, underneath a little bit, okay, pull, you can get those clips out. Somebody broke them. Okay, here it's supposed to be another one. It's broken. Here, we're supposed to have two and one there. One is already broken, two are broken, one is good. Somebody didn't take care of it, guys. We need to disconnect ignition coils. How you do that? You pull that piece back. Okay, it's supposed to be back, okay, closed like that. Grab it, pull it like that, push down. Okay, let's do this one so I can show you a little bit better. Now push down here and pull it out. We do that to all four ignition coils. Here, guys, you have the camshaft position sensor. Press down, pull it out as well, and disconnect it from, okay, from that coolant pipe right here. This is the PCV valve hose. Pull it out. Perfect. Next, guys, what do we need to do? That wiring harness is loose on this side, as you can see. We need to start, guys, okay, removing here ignition coils. 10 millimeter socket, and we can start on that now. Perfect. Grab each one of them, pull them straight out. Okay, great. Now, what else, guys, we need to do? We need to, guys, okay, start right here that coolant pipe. We'll need to remove that one. So here you will need to unscrew that post for the engine cover. Just grab it and unscrew it like that. After that, 10 millimeter nut. remove that one. And you can just pull that one gently, careful not to break it there. Okay. Gently pull it up. Perfect. Okay, and we'll leave it on the side. Now, let's see what else we have right here. Wiring harness goes on top of this bolt, pull it out. And from that point on, I think all we will need is 8mm deep socket, guys. And we'll start removing bolts. We'll show you where every bolt is located now, so you can remove the valve cover. Let's start on it now. 1, 2, 3. Now we start on this side, 4 guys. 5 bolts. 6 here. 7. 8. Okay, there we have 9 in the corner. 10. 11. 12, right behind the spark plugs. 13. 14, guys. Here, one more underneath that wiring harness. 15 bolts on the outside, 4 on the inside now. So altogether we have 19 bolts. Now that valve cover may be stuck, so you may just gently pry it here with a screwdriver. If it doesn't come out, guys, after prying it a little bit, probably some bolt is still holding. Make sure, because here you have a little bit of silicone, even though it's a gasket where the timing cover meets with the cylinder head. You have a little bit of silicone, and you have a little bit of silicone towards the last cap right before the vacuum pump. Grab it, guys, and pull it out. Okay, you can see just like that, it came out. So we can pre-loosen this now, these 3 bolts for the pulley, water pump pulley. So just get them loose, don't remove them. We do that while the belt is holding, that way the pulley will not be spinning. Now we can go ahead and remove the belt. 16mm socket, we go counterclockwise and we can go ahead and remove the belt out. Okay, just like that. Great, it came out. So with the wrench, guys, or a breaker bar, it's almost impossible to get that bolt loose. Okay, we're going to bring it to TDC point, okay. So now the crankshaft pulley bolt, it's impossible to take it with a breaker bar unless you guys damage something. So what we use, guys, our setup here, DeWalt air compressor. You can find the links in the description of the video below. Very little compressor, only 6 gallons, but it goes all the way to 165 PSI. This is amazing. And Ingersoll Rand, guys, impact, very powerful impact. And we'll go ahead and remove it with a 22mm socket now. Okay, perfect. You can see, and it came out. Now we can go ahead and remove the pulley, guys, all the way. Okay, just like that. So what do we need to do next, guys? We need to start removing, okay, the water pump pulley, okay, all the way out. You can see it comes out super easy. Next, we need to remove the idle pulley here and the tensioner pulley. There is one difference. The idle pulley is a regular thread, the tensioner pulley is a reverse thread. So it's pretty tight, we'll use the ratchet. Okay, hasn't been removed for a while. Perfect, came out. Now the one on top, okay, it's a 16mm socket, guys. This one is 16mm and it's a reverse threaded socket, actually. Bolt. Perfect. Okay, great. Now We need to start removing the bolts. We're going to change the battery quick on the impact, and you're going to see, guys, all the bolts on the timing cover will need to be removed. We're going to start. Okay, you can see you have this bolt, this here, here. You have a few underneath here, and you have to remove the the bracket for the AC compressor on the bottom, and we need to go all the way around. So make sure you stay until the end, and we'll show you what needs to be done now. So we'll start with the 10 millimeter bolts first. Now we have a few here. This is for the open. Now, guys, we need to remove the bracket for the AC compressor, because underneath it there is a hidden bolt. One hidden bolt. And we'll explain where it's located. So we'll need to remove that bolt now right here. Okay, you can see the bottom bolt on the AC compressor, 13 millimeter socket. We get it out. Now we have three bolts, I believe. Okay, holding that bracket to the oil pan and the engine block and the timing cover. So 12 millimeter socket now. We move the engine a little bit, guys, so we can show you. Once we remove the bracket, I will be able to show you exactly where the bolts are. Okay, and we should have one more after that, in the corner here. So after this one, that bracket will come loose. Okay, and let me show you where all the bolts are now. So you can see 1, 2, 3 bolts that we had to remove. Now 10 millimeter socket, and we have that hidden bolt for the open that we need to remove. Okay, and we got this one out. Next, we continue, guys, with the 13 millimeter or 12 millimeter. Next, we're going to switch to 13. Now we switch to 15 millimeter and we'll be almost ready, guys. We'll show you what sealant to use for the timing cover. It works really, really good. And it's way better looking than that red one. I just don't like the red one. I'm not a big fan of it. The one that we use, it's gray. It's Max Torque. Really good quality. Now we have two guides. Let me explain quick. Okay, right here you have a guide. Right here, it may be stuck. Now you have to be very gentle how you pry that thing, because if it's stuck, it can crack super easy, guys. We've broken a few in the past from not being careful. So be careful. Gently start. Okay. Prying on one side, switch on the other side a little bit. Don't just go all of a sudden. Okay, and this one came easier than usually it does. So, what do you guys use to clean that later and reseal it? Let's explain quick. You get a scraper, guys. Okay, you can find the one that we're using here with the long handle, super handy. In the description of the video below, we'll have the link, guys. And you're going to clean everything with that scraper. Make sure that you clean the whole surface of the timing cover and the engine block as well. But you have to be careful not to drop things in the oil pan, unless you're planning on removing the oil pan too. And after that, we're using, guys, the silicone. Okay, it's a gasket maker right here, ultra gray. Okay, this is the good stuff, guys, right here. This thing is amazing. Okay, it's a gasket maker, maximum torque, so it works really good. And it's gray in color, so it's not so visible. We'll have a video how to reseal it if you want to check it out, guys. But that's what needs to be used. So that's how you guys remove the timing cover, as you can see. For installation and resealing, we explain what needs to be done. But if you want to check the torque specs and all that, we'll have the video coming soon, guys. We're planning on making the video when we start putting the engine together. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos. And if you have any questions, leave a comment below. See you guys next time.